Hello and welcome back, dear friends. It's Odo, and we are back in our campaign of Europa Universalis IV with Ethiopia. We are just wrecking our southern neighbors. We are doing this more or less friendly. This guy leading this army and not this guy. No. Go here. Better. Hey, we gained 50 military points, that's good. And we can take the engineer core. And we get one diplomatic reputation, that's good. With this plus 20% siege ability, we should be faster with the sieges. 22 days for one siege phase. Let's go further down there. Triumph of the clergy. This doesn't sound good. While none would openly defy the clergy, there are a few states where they are as influential as in Ethiopia. There isn't a single institution in our country that isn't entirely under the influence of the clergy. The power of our Negusa Nagas depends on them. Now more than ever. It is perhaps only natural that the clergy now also wishes to take a more active role in the practical ruling of our country. Okay, what do they want? Clerical dominance. Stability cost modifier plus 15%. Clergy states gains 10 influence until 1532. Okay, and the second thing, lose stability. Lose influence and loyalty. Okay. Let's let them triumph. Oops. Separatists taken control of Malindi. Yes, what shall we do? Okay, We have 106%. Oof. 15, 17 it's now. When do we lose something? 15, 22. Okay, there will be some problems. Yes, there will be some problems. Okay, the burgers are the blue ones. If we take them away, there's probably some revolt. Could this be? Probably, yes. But this disaster will start very soon, as it gets +5 each month. I really don't know what the plutocratic coup does. I really don't know that. Can you tell me what the plutocratic would have the following effects? Morale of army -10%, national manpower modifier -25%, land force limit modifier -25%, yearly prestige -1. That's not too bad, probably. We could try to get through this. I mean, it doesn't show that we have more rebels in the land after the plutocratic coup. It's just that our military is less strong. We should make some pause in attacking anyway. Stop. Let's take Zanzibar. Come on. Really? We had another disease outbreak. That's not nice of you. Peace offer from Kilva. What do they offer? Sisima, Lindi, and Mombasa. War reparations. 100 ducats. Yeah, let's accept this. So, let's build a castle here in Kilva, shall we? Rebel uprisings in Marihan. Where is Marihan separatists? Where are they? Beja, Marihan. Oh no. Here they are. No, here are the Marehan separatists. Why didn't you go there? Do I have some corks? Yes, I do have some corks. Let's go here. The rest of you will protect the trade in the Gulf of Aden again. Okay, come here, separatists. We'll take care of you. So, where do we have the big separatists, Marian separatists? Where are they? In Las Corées. Okay, let's increase this for some time. Oh, we have a lot of rebels here. You really have to get rid of them. Comet sighted. It's an omen. Lose one stability. The end is nigh. Lose one stability. The economy fools. Okay. Can we do anything? No. It's an omen. Let's take this. I really hate you. Won the Battle of Mombasa. they're not black flagged. So let's do this and that. So, how about this institution stuff? Is there any chance of us getting this institution? The next one? No. We really have to do this by ourselves. So, how about you getting here? And you getting down there? That's okay. Come on. religious zeal. Shipyard, marketplace, yeah, that's okay. Some trade in peat. We have some. That's good. Another revolt, yeah. Oh my god, 16,000 troops. Really? Hey, we converted some heretics. Let's do this also for the heretics in Kosti. Ah, yes. We still have the prosperity here. That's good. That's very good, as we want to get angered. To embrace the colonialism. We are at 30%. No. Oh god. I'm so stupid. I should have turned on the edict first. Looming disaster. Yeah, that's really looming. Deborah Barron, the Mountain of Light. Had a vision in which he has been shown a shining mountain on which to build the new capital of Ethiopia. A church has already been constructed at the site, and now it is up to the state to realize the dream of our emperor. Really? Has come for a permanent capital. Lose 25 administration Sheva renamed to Deborah Barron. We lose local autonomy. Let us not break with tradition. Plus one stability is not that bad. Like Sheva, where is Sheva? Here is Sheva. Volo, where is Volo? They've got 25% because they are also they Ankuba. Where is Ankuba? There is Ankuba. Also has the nobility Janjiro and Damot. Damot has 25% and the burghers, and Janjiro, where is Janjiro? I really don't see it. Oh, here is Janjiro. They don't have autonomy. Let us not break with tradition. Let's gain some stability. Okay. Four ships. Let's transport them there. And we don't have any truce with the Mamluks. Again, they are in this array. They really do have a lot of revolutions, like we. But we have more control about these revolutions than they. Let's move here. You move here. How about this region? They don't have any unrest. Yeah, that's good. No unrest. Some unrest. Let's get rid of the unrest. So, devastation. How about this 4? It's already done. But we have a devastation of 27 here. Really? I mean, that's a lot of devastation. And 35. We destroyed a lot of land here. So, like, Dongola will not likely rise to prosperity. These countries, but these provinces will probably sooner than later, and also this one again, this one as well, and even this state will get some prosperity soon, this not. Also not this. I mean, that's okay. We don't need the prosperity everywhere. So I will stop again this time of the evening, and next time we will see what this plutocratic coup will do. I will probably look at the wiki what it does, but until then I wish you a pleasant night, sleep well, and until then.